right. Greed works.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to episode 33 of Let's Play Wall Street Raider. I'm RakeM, your host. Today, we are continuing down our path towards domination of the oil industry. Our total net worth is down from our peak of like $150 trillion, but that's mostly a function of the interest rate because we have a bank whose stock price is heavily influenced by the interest rate. So with the interest rate this high, we are seeking to invest as much money as possible in bonds at both the banks, the bank and our five insurance companies. We are making plenty of cash off of our swaps and off of the bonds that we have already because the return on those bonds are all above 10% per year. So we're getting 2.5 to 3% per quarter on trillions of dollars worth of bonds. So we're reinvesting that money into more bonds because when the price goes down and the interest rate goes down, the price of the bonds will go up. So at that point, our stock prices will not only recover but rebound, you know, even higher than they were before. So we're going to make some money off of options and also off of buying and selling the stock as the interest rate goes up and down. When those bonds start to get close to their maturity date, we'll start to think about selling them off and taking profit out of the bonds themselves. But for right now, we're just going to take advantage of their volatility. All right, as far as commodities go, last episode we made some money off of corn, but now he's too high. We're going to leave him alone. Plus, we still have a lot of work to do on our stocks, and we can't really divide our attention very well. So we're mainly just dealing with gold and silver, both of which have kind of been a disappointment. We bought them when they were low. We're still making money on the commodity trades that we have, but their prices have really not hit their targets. There's been some up and down with them, but not enough to actually sell it and then buy it back and all that stuff. So right now we have the full 50,000 contracts in gold and 50,000 contracts in silver. I personally have the full amount of physical gold and the full amount of physical silver as well. Berkshire Hathaway, however, only has the gold. All right, which is my holding company. The oil price is climbing, which is kind of spoiling our plans over in the oil industry because it's propping up the earnings and the stock prices. And the higher this climbs, the harder it's going to be to get those stock prices down without actually killing the industry outright. So we're just kind of playing a waiting game. If he gets up above 140, we'll go ahead and buy futures of him. Or I don't mean buy, I mean sell short. But still, you know, we're hoping for this to go down, honestly. We'll make more money taking over the oil industry than we will in a single commodity trade. So right now, we're rooting for this to go down. Now, if it goes up, all's not lost. We just have to wait a little while longer. But still, we'd like to take over that industry sooner rather than later. ZDNet in that industry, his stock price went all the way down to 97, and now he's back up to 135 because of this. All right, so what we're doing today is we are going through all of our other stocks, all the non-oil stocks, and we are making sure that they're going to earn decent earnings, make sure that they have decent earnings, and if they're not, then we do everything we can to achieve it in the future. All right, we've split a whole bunch of our stocks. There's still a few outliers that we haven't split. We're going to hit all of those today and just make any adjustments that we feel need to be made. Anyone that has debt, we're going to pay it off. Anyone that is ready to sell, we're going to sell them and replace them. And if the interest rate gets, you know, changes to easing, if the policy changes to easing and the interest rate goes down, that is when I will merge Tokio Marine into the bank. And what that'll do is it will cancel all of these options, which right now are going to be worthless if this stock price doesn't come up. So I can't really exercise this option because the strike price is higher than the current price. You know, why buy the stock for 25 when I can buy it from the public at 19? So we need for this price to go up for these options to have any value at all. The other way to do it is to go ahead and merge it now, but that'll cancel all of these. and I'm counting on the interest rate to go down to where these have more value than what's shown here. Okay. And we still have 2 years before those options expire, because they don't expire until December or until 2028. So we got plenty of time for the interest rate to go down. Okay, I think that's everything I need to talk about. I do want to check on the stocks that I've shorted, Arab and Exxon, before we really get started. I know I've made money on them. I'm not sure how much. So here, against Exxon, I've made about $400 billion. And against Arab, I was earning more earlier, you know, last episode, but now it's only $140 billion. We need them to go down. Matter of fact, I would, if it wasn't so expensive in terms of future earnings, I would go ahead and drive them to bankruptcy. But what will happen if I do that is we'll lose all of these assets, and they have combined over $1 trillion worth of assets. So we're basically just trying to drive the earnings down by growing at this high rate, and I'm actually going to move it back up to 60 to hasten this process. All right, so let's go ahead and increase to 60. ZDNet still has plenty of cash, and $2 trillion in assets is enough to weather any problems with antitrust suits, because we will be making enough money off of that $2 trillion in order to be able to afford to just settle every antitrust suit that comes our way. Even if they're for $250 billion apiece, we would be able to weather that storm. Because only one comes per month, so the maximum that you're going to have to deal with is $750 per quarter. And as long as the returns are 20% or above, you can handle that. Okay, so we picked up BP and Imperial Petroleum through bankruptcies. BP was part of a big, you know, trust held by Citigroup. And there's a whole bunch of companies that Citigroup held that we're going to have to deal with today. But a lot of them have swaps, and so we're not entirely opposed to the rest of them going broke via the swaps. And we'll just deal with that as it comes. So let's go to our list here, and basically we're going to go down. Actually, you know what? Let's not start here. Let's go over to the insurance companies, starting with TMFI, and I just want to look down and see if there's any that are priced above 50, and there's not. Okay, so let's go over to the bank, and there's Citigroup that we have to deal with, but let's go through all the stocks that are held by the insurance companies and see if there's any that we haven't split, and if any of them have one that we haven't split, it's because we haven't looked at it and we need to. All right, so Venfin Tobacco we haven't looked at, so let's go take a look at him. Wow, he's losing a lot of money, and it's because of this guy. 42% in a negative industry. All right, let's change our growth rate to zero. We are very incompetent, which is another reason why we're losing money. And we're spending 16%. So let's double down here. Let's increase our growth rate, or reduce our growth rate to zero, and increase our R&D to 21. All right, let's eliminate the dividend if there is one, but there isn't. Okay, good. And now let's split him. And he's going to need some more money, because he's losing money right now. So let's give him $500 million. All right. Now, that was the only one, right? Yeah, that was the only one. All right, so let's go to the next one. Those are all in line, okay. All right, so here we have some Sigma freebies and I guess that's it. We already sold off Warner Lambert, so it's time to update this list too, because we sold off a few of these. We sold off JCPenney, Warner Lambert, Burger King we sold. I think we sold Bausch & Lomb too. Alright, so anyway, let's look at Sigma. Let's pay off his loan. All he has is stocks that he's invested in passively. Okay, he's not a controlling interest in any of these. So, we'll just split him. All right, next up, freebies. I guess we haven't looked at them because nothing really has gone bankrupt in this industry. Costco is awful affordable now. And that would give us 32%. He has no debt and he's paying, and he's for, okay, this is a bargain right here. Let's go back to who owns freebies, Zurich. Zurich have cash? He's a little light on cash. Much cash does freebies have? Okay. What do we want to do here? Who has cash? Berkshire has cash. SunTrust has cash. Hartford and Irish have cash. But they already have 13 stocks each, so and we can't contribute cash from the bank because we got too much money in stocks. So the only other thing to do would be for me to buy it until freebies or Zurich can afford to buy it from me. I guess we can do that. All right, so the returns are kind of low in there, so we're gonna change things up and we're just gonna grow negative. Let this guy exhaust his credit target and try to drive up the earnings a little bit. And so we're gonna grow at -5 on both of those. Alright, that should be good enough for now. And I'm making a ton of money from somewhere. I guess it's from silver going up. Yeah, silver's way up. So we want him to hit 18, that's our sell point. It'd be nice if he hit 20, but 18's our cutoff. So if he hits 18 and then starts to go down, we're just going to let him go. Gold, of course, we're going to hang on until he hits 2,000. We don't need to get creative with him. Okay, so let's see. Let's go back to Zurich and see who else needs to be split there. All right, so we still need to split freebies. But he's the only one left. And let's look at Costco because I don't remember what his stock price was. All right, so he's fine. All right, now let's go through all the ones that are negative, especially the ones that are big negative, like -$3 and more. And some of these are bankruptcies that we probably ought to take care of first. We'll need to address each one of them. So let's go to the bank and clear out the bankruptcies, I guess, first to clean up this list. All right, so starting with Mitsubishi. Oh, this is bookstores. Super small, don't want it. We'll just sell it. All right, so now we gotta unravel Citigroup. Basically, he's got a ton of debt and everything that he owns is in stocks. So anything that's reasonably priced and same as the other bankruptcies, anything that's reasonably priced and doesn't put us over a 30% market share, we'll probably buy it away from Citigroup. All right, so first of all, Citibank we don't want. We don't control it, so we'll just sell that. Bank of America, probably the same deal, except that he has a lot of stocks. All right, so let's go to Merrill Lynch and see. Okay, he's trading too high, but he's got 15% of the market, so let's buy his assets away from him. All right, what does he have? He's got 55. All right. And Nico has 2,000, so we need to give him 50 billion. Actually, let's make it 60 billion. And we don't have that quite yet, but we're gonna in just a minute. As soon as we hit the new year, we're going to. So let's give him 55. Buy Merrill Lynch's assets. And I guess we'll buy these as well. All right. So now we're going to need cash, but we can have him give Nico some more cash. All right, so Merrill Lynch. He doesn't have any tax loss carryovers to worry about. And the bank will take a loss if we liquidate it, and that's what we want to do. We want to liquidate and have the bank take a loss. He's not wholly owned, so we'll do a taxable liquidation. Oh, if we liquidate it, we'll lose the swap. We might want to leave him. Might want to leave him so that we can continue to profit off the swap that we have with him. I mean, he's going to cost Bank of America money anyway. We don't have to liquidate him all at once. We can have the swaps liquidate him. Let's take a look and see what swaps he has. Got two, one with the bank and one with Irish. All right, we'll just leave him for now. All right, what's next on the list here? Yellow Freight. We don't care about this industry. See Ito. We don't have a controlling interest, so it doesn't matter. Applied Microcircuits is in semiconductor. We got enough already. We're already pretty much a monopoly, so we'll leave that alone. champion is in paper products. We've got plenty there already, so we don't care about it. We don't care about textiles and apparel. It's real small. And looks like we need to sell this off too. All right, Malincrot. All right, him we may want, but no, he's trading too high. So we don't want him. Okay, Florida Light and Power. And him, he's one we want. Him we'll take. All right, so let's go to Southern California Ed and buy him. And now we'll liquidate him. Pay off our loan. And if we have bonds, we'll buy those back, but we don't. Okay. What's our management there now? Reasonably competent. We need to cancel the swap too. All right, so that's it as far as Bank of America is concerned. We don't want any of the rest. So we want BP, but we don't want the bank. All right, so let's sell off the bank. Because we don't need the semiconductor company Applied Materials causing us to have a monopoly. Okay. So now we need to deal with these. Mitsui, we don't own our controlling interest, so we can just sell that off. For a loss, of course. All right, BP. He's trading almost at cost. All right, I think ZDNet owns Imperial. It does. So let's have him buy BP too. All right, so let's set his dividend to zero. But otherwise, we'll leave it alone. All right, let's go back to Citigroup. All right, so Travelers. He's mostly bonds. Let's see what he has in the terms of stock. Two small ones. Might be interested in Smith Barney right here. Well, we would be if he wasn't going bankrupt. Okay. And this one, he's going bankrupt too. So we're not interested in this guy. So let's sell him off also. And Citigroup is not a holding company, he's an advertising. So we can have TMP World buy his assets. Yeah, let's do that. All right, so now he's a holding company with only cash. That's all he's got. All right, so question is, do we want to do anything with him? And the answer is yes, but I'm going to keep that a secret for now. He'll be part of the integrated oil takeover. I'll explain it later. All right, so let's go through here and look at the ones that are either that are negative. Let's start with them, and then the ones that are whose earnings are going down left to right. Okay, so we'll start at the top and work our way down. And who owns him? Because I don't remember us. How did Vertex get him? We don't want him. Let's sell him off. Okay, so we'll go through the list and deal with everything that's going on. So start at the top and we'll work our way down. All right, so he went from 74 cents and he's projected to have 70. We're expanding at a huge rate. He's still got some cash, but he's running out. And our return is negative, and this is why. They're growing huge. So it's time to freeze these guys. And so this is Procter & Gamble, Clorox, and Warner-Lambert. So let's go over to the bank and freeze them. Got a lot of banks that are going to go bankrupt while we're trying to do this. So, all right, so Clorox first. And he's not there. Do we not own his loan? Hey, well, let's go to buy, sell, and see if his loan's for sale. Okay, so there's a bunch on here. All right, so I'm going to buy these up real quick, and I'll be right back. That's and it just occurred to me that CL is probably Colgate, not Clorox, so we got to go back and look and see. All right, so yeah, CL, Colgate Palmolive. All right, so we'll freeze him. Procter & Gamble. And Warner Lambert. All right, so let's go back to Amway and see if there's anyone else. Both these are going bankrupt, and Wrigley's in bad shape too, so we'll just leave that the way it is. Now let's give him a little bit extra cash. All right, so let's give him $2 billion. All right. And I think while this interest rate is this high, we're going to have Tokyo Marine and Fire do some swaps. SunTrust's earnings are up, which is surprising at this interest rate. But the swaps probably had a lot to do with it. $600 billion on interest rate swaps. For nearly a trillion altogether. All right, so let's go to Tokyo Marine and Fire. And let's do some long swaps. I don't expect it to let us to do very many, but any we can do is income for him. So I'm going to do as many as it'll let me, and I'll be right back. I think it let me do 34, but let's count them. That's 17, 34, 35, 6, 7, 8, 9, 40, 41. So we got 41 of them in. All right, so next up, Ann Taylor is fine. Barrick is fine. Oh, I guess we didn't sell Bosch and Lomb after all, so he's fine. Fine, fine, fine. Okay, BP. Now, we don't really care if he's negative, and even if he is, we're not going to do anything about it, but let's take a look over here. Exxon is finally ready for us to start taking him over. So we're going to have ZDNet buy 19% of Exxon. Let's see how much that's going to be. Okay, so it's going to be right about $100 billion, a little bit more, maybe $120. So we're going to have to borrow a little bit, but that's fine. And it's time for me to cover my short position on that. Okay, so now let's see what Arab is worth. He is worth too much still. He bought Bank of America. That was a dumb move. Okay, so he's still got some money left. He must have issued some bonds and he's still going into debt. Let's freeze him. And do I really want to do that? I guess not. I guess it would be better for us to let him continue to borrow with the rate at 12.5%. His return is down from the 23% range down to 19, but he has stopped growing and he's cut his R&D way down. Okay, Petrofina, Sigma owns 19% of that. Let's have ZDNet buy it from Sigma. The earnings on all of our insurance companies is going up, which is good. All right, next, we don't need to buy Marathon because he's going broke. We already own BP, so all that's left is Mobile. Yep, Mobile and Arab is all that's left for our takeover, and he's kind of low now, so let's see what his projected earnings are. Anytime now. There we go. He's going to lose money. So his stock price will probably go down if we wait for their declaration, which is in a week. So we'll wait and buy 19% of him when his stock price goes down after the next earnings report. Okay. So, that's BP out of the way. Citigroup is back into the positive category, so fine. He's on his way up, but he's still negative, so let's take a look. Swiss is up. All right, so we're growing at 0% because Burger King is growing at 55%. So, do we want to freeze him or not? And seeing as how he's costing us money, I think we're going to go ahead and freeze him. I'd like for him to have more debt, but it's more important that we make a profit. So, more important that we make a profit off Darden than it is off of the interest on the loan. So, let's go freeze Burger King. Irish, his earnings are down, but that's mostly because the interest rate swaps are losing money. He had losses of 82,000 or 82 billion on interest rate swaps because the interest rate's so high. So even though he has long swaps, they're at like, if I remember correctly, they're at 11% and the interest rate's at 12.5%, so he would have lost money, a little bit of money that this quarter. Let's go see what cash he has left. He didn't have to borrow anything, which is good, and he still has $30 billion, so he's all right. He's still making money, he's just not making as much money as he was. Let's go back to Darden and see if there's anything else we want to do. I mean, zero is fine. We're supposed to make 26% or 23%, so I'm not sure exactly why we're losing money. Oh, yes, swaps. Well, let's get rid of those. We should have gotten rid of these before. Okay, so let's see what else we can do for him, if anything. He needs money again. He needs, $10 billion. So let's give him that. All right, and let's see what commodities he has. He's got gold that he bought at $792. All right, let's get rid of that as well. All right, so he's reasonably competent, so 8% is fine. And just the industry is deteriorating, that's what we need to fix. That, between that and the swaps, we should be back in positive territory. So once he comes down, our earnings should go way up. And we're going to pick up Pizza Hut. And I don't think there's anybody else that we want to add. So that's it for him. Let's see what happens when the earnings get refigured at the end of next quarter. Okay, so that was Darden. This one's fine. Fine. All right, Dr. Pepper. Yeah, it looks good financially. Let's see what we have over here. We're still going up from last year. Well, I don't know why. Okay, this is weird. I guess, I know what it was. He was losing all kinds of money last year, but he finished positive. because we had this big return. So we're still gonna be up technically. So let's look at the industry. Okay, and once again we have Pepsi growing at all kinds of outrageous figures here. So let's freeze Pepsi and Cott. And we can leave the other two alone. They're okay. Because they don't have a lot of credit left anyway. He doesn't have any, really. How can he grow that fast? He can't. So we don't need to freeze Cott. We just need to freeze Pepsi. Alright, so let's go over to SunTrust and freeze Pepsi. Alright, and I don't see anything else that needs to be done. When these guys, this one, this is Coca-Cola, looks like he's going to go broke. And these others here all are going to go broke. And when they do, these returns will go up. So between that and freezing Pepsi, we should be fine. You know, we only just merged him altogether, so he's going to go up. All right, so what's after Dr. Pepper? All right, here we're going up. We're kind of flattening out. Oh, this is a bankruptcy we just got. He's at kind of a high premium already. Newmont already has a big enough share, so let's just sell him off. Wow, that's a big loss on a loan to Leonard. We'll have to look at him real quick here. Well, let's look at, or sell off LVAL. Looks like we're picking up all kinds of stuff in the housing development. So let's go there and take a look. Yeah, we've already got a monopoly here. So we can sell off Del Webb and grow these other two up instead. So we can make a profit on him and we can start over with these two. All right, so let's do that. So we'll have Irish sell Del Webb. Buy Leonard and Walter Industries. Well, Leonard has a lot of subsidiaries. Let's see what they are. Oh, he's got some of our cast-offs. Guess I should have looked before I bought him, huh? Alright, so let's reduce this one's growth rate to negative 10. Same here. At least until these other two decide to come down, or other three decide to come down. I think we're going to have to go back over and look at the bank again, see how many bankruptcies he's got. And here we just have to sell Grace off. All right, so let's liquidate Walter Industries into Leonard. Thank you. And there's Marathon Oil. So as soon as we finish liquidating Walter Industries, let's go check and see if that other stock is ready to buy now. Mobile. He's come down. He declared -1, and his next one is supposed to be 2 cents. And he's come down from $8 a share to 4, or almost, well, 5. Alright, so we'll have ZDNet. Oh, we don't have to because he's owned by Exxon. Okay, we don't need to buy this one. This one we're going to get through our acquisition of Exxon. Okay, so Arab's the only one we need to worry about now. And his return is still coming down. And he's got 40 billion less. $40 billion less in cash. The only problem is that this is going up again. The oil price is going up again. Let's see, 20% of 1.5 trillion would be what, 300 billion? I mean, we could still do that. It's just more than I want to spend. I'd like to have this down to, you know, 600 billion and spend 200 instead of 600. But you can't get everything, I guess. We're going to give it a little more time and see if we can get it down. Exxon's going way down in his stock price. So we have the conditions on everybody exactly lined up the way we wanted, except for Arab. Arab, we need to go down a little bit more. So it looks like hopefully we'll be able to take this over next episode. I wonder if we should freeze his credit. I mean, he's got a little bit of credit left. All he's doing is spending his cash right now. But I mean, he's not really growing, so. It can't hurt. Let's just go ahead and freeze him. Alright, back to our list. Let's see, we haven't dealt with the bankruptcies yet, so we got to Dr. Pepper, so Ecolab's next, he's fine. This one's fine. Enzo's a bankruptcy, and he's in electrical equipment. And we need to sell him off. Either that or sell Siemens and start working with him. Siemens, we can make 3 times our money. Before taxes, I mean. Let's see, if we sold him, there's plenty of people that can buy them. Of course, all these top 8 are ours. So Arabian could buy him, probably. No, he's out of credit. He can't do it. Can't do it, can't do it, can't do it. Google could buy him, probably. Let's see. 80% would be probably be about 375, somewhere in there. Let's see what kind of credit he's got. Yeah, he's got a lot, but he can't afford 400,000 though. So I guess if we sold 80% of Siemens, we could still do the extraordinary dividend for all of his cash so that we're not leaving him with fantastic credit. So let's do that. Let's sell 80% of him. All right, and public owns 80% now, so let's do an extraordinary dividend for the full amount. And now Swiss can sell the rest. Okay, and now let's buy Enzo. Oh boy, and Enzo had a bunch of stocks too. All right, so let's just go through these one by one. The first one we should look at is Saatchi & Saatchi because he's in advertising and we have a pretty big market share there already. So let's sell him off because he's putting us into monopoly status. Okay, next is FEMSA. See if we want Saab to buy him, or excuse me, Dr. Pepper. And he's below 100%, so yeah, let's merge those two together. And liquidate him. And now let's pay off the loan. Okay. Alright, pay less drug. We don't have anything in drugstores. Let's see how big it is. Walgreens has 37%. So it's big enough. So let's buy Apex and merge it with these two. All right, so let's get Tokyo involved. He's got cash, so let's buy Apex. Let's buy Rexall Drug. Oh, I already own that one. Okay, cool. Alright, so then the other one was Payless. Alright, let's merge those three together. All right, let's give him $2 billion. Okay, now let's see, we need to split him. Let's see what we need to do for him management wise. We don't need to grow negative, so let's make this 5%. And we're reasonably competent, so we can reduce our R&D to 8%. And our dividend should be 32 cents, so let's increase that. That looks good. Okay. And who did we buy Enzo from? Leonard, right? Okay. We're going to get to that in a second. So, Morton, he's trading at too high a price, so let's sell him. And CKE, way down here, we've got a big enough market share, so let's sell him off too. And it looks like we need to get over to brewing and deal with what's going on over there, because everybody's going bankrupt and we're going to end up with a market share too that's too big. All right, so we need to pay this down, so we need 20 billion for that, but we already have 5, so let's give him 16. Okay, and our antitrust suit is going to court, and we lost. All right, so Enzo doesn't have any more loan, and he's projected to make a profit, but it's down. We're very capable, so we can reduce our R&D to 6%. And I think we want to go ahead and keep growing like this, because GE is about to go broke. And we'll pick him up, and then we can grow at a lower rate. So, since he's already at 6, I'm going to make this 7. And everything else I'm going to leave alone. Okay, let's go over to the brewing industry. See where we stand. Oh, okay, so we're all right. I thought we had a bigger share over here. So we'll merge these two into SAB Miller. Alright, 10% is okay. It's not great. What's our management like now? Reasonably competent. Alright, so let's back our R&D down to 12%. Looks like we got to go deal with our bankruptcies again. All right, so still up from last year. So not going to make any other changes, just going to leave that. All right, so let's go over to the bank. See how many bankruptcies we have now. So that's 9, 10, 11. So we got to deal with these. All right, so anything less than 500 million, I just want to sell off. There's only one of those, and that's Amgen. So we'll just merge them with Vertex. And they're currently being offered for sale. So, do we not own 100% of him? How can they be offered for sale when I've got 100% of it? Do you want to cancel this? Okay, no. We'll just buy it. let's pay off the loan. All right, next, Unum Corp. Oh, he's an insurance company. And he's bankrupt. So, let's sell him off. Olin Corp is in chemicals commodity. And that's where we have Shenzhen. It's trading at 91%. So let's just merge him with Shenzhen. More stuff in the shipping industry going bankrupt. Alright, so since there were two in there, we'll take a look and see if we want to merge them with our company there. We've got a big enough market share already, but these guys are pretty cheap. Alright, so that would give us 37.40. I don't really want to have that big a share. Of course, the returns are pretty good, and we can grow negative if we need to. All right, let's merge it and let's change our growth rate to 1%. See if we can preserve these high returns for a while. So let's see. Starting with OSG. And then Mitsui Osk was the other one, right? All right, so we're reasonably competent. And we need some money. So let's give them another $3 billion. Okay, that looks good. Seem to be losing money somewhere. Probably silver. Silver is way down. Let's go over to Berkshire Hathaway and have him buy silver now while it's this low. And oil is getting real close. So we'll want to buy that if it gets up above 140. Spot corn's getting down to where it's almost worth buying too. Okay, back to the bankruptcies. Cadbury Schweppes. He's trading at an ultra low price, so we'll have Ralston buy him. CompuWare just went broke. So we'll merge him into Intuit. Alright, Norfolk and Southern. We've already got a big enough market share here. Returns are pretty good though. All right, so let's have Union Pacific merge with him. All right, so Marathon Oil. We need to have Zurich take him off our hands. And give him some money, probably, too. He's still being stubborn. Still up there in the 300% range. And the interest rate continues to go up, too. I want that to come down. He's too expensive. He's got to come down. I mean, he's come down from 1.5 to 1.35, but still, I want it down some more. I want this down around 600. All right, so anyway, we'll have him buy MRO from the bank. And contribute $2 billion to MRO so that he doesn't go broke again. Alright, we got too big a market share here, and Owens Corning is trading at too high a price anyway. So we'll just sell him. Johnson & Johnson. We've got a big enough market share already. So we'll just sell him off. Mazda USA. That's where Nissan is. All the guys above us have no credit. Well, Honda has a little bit, but with that dividend, it's not going to last long. So let's see how Nissan is faring. Yeah, we can buy him. Let's just buy it up. This is also an insurance company. He's got Narada Mining. Or Naranda Mining. And he can sue Newmont Gold if he hasn't already. Avgenix sued and lost. So let's see. It's already seeking damages, so he's already filed. So let's keep him separate for now. It doesn't look like he has any swaps. So we'll have Barrick buy him but not merge with him until the antitrust has been resolved. All right, so let's go back to Provident. That's all he's got. He's currently bankrupt, so let's just sell the rest of him off. Okay, that's it. Now, it hasn't escaped my attention that we're up to 100 billion now, or 100 trillion, I mean. The stock index is down, and the interest rate is way up, 13%. So, and the GDP has gone from 1.9 to 1.0 in the last month. Wow, look at that. Silver went down some more. Let's have Citigroup buy some silver too. that's all he can afford. Who can afford to buy the full amount? Because that price on silver is just too good. Well, I guess anybody else that did it would have to do it on credit. But we don't really want anyone using their credit right now because we are just, you know, days away from taking over the integrated oil industry. And we're going to need about $500 billion to do that, just to take it over. And then we're going to need more money to consolidate all of the assets into a single entity there. So, and we don't have the funds to do it even between all of our companies here. So I think we're just going to have to pass this opportunity by. As much as I'd like to take advantage of it, the only other way to do it is to sell off some of our stocks. But I don't know of any that are ready to sell. So I'll do some research in between this episode and the next to see if there's a way to do both. But we've been going for over an hour now, so I'm going to end the episode here. If you enjoyed the episode, please like and share. And until next time, this is RakeM saying, have a good one.